The most popular Kalashnikov rifle in the Russian army was its modernized version, known as AKM. This rifle was designed about 65 years ago, same as the Kalashnikov RPK handheld light machine gun. 2 years after their construction, a first jump magazine in USSR was created. However, instead of just using it with the RPK machine gun only, soldiers used it with the AK rifle. The Russians were fond of the jump magazine and called it Bubin, which means tambourine, or Olitka, which means nail, because it resembled those objects. Jump mags were cute ray in the Soviet army and were widely appreciated by special forces and experienced Russian soldiers. But in this episode we're talking about why jump magazines are really a bad idea, where have almost all AK jump mags in the Russian army gone, and why do Russian soldiers barely use them nowadays? My name is Kasper, this info is only available on this channel, so stay with us! So, on 8 April 1959, the modernized Kalashnikov AKM rifle and the RPK machine gun were adopted in the USSR, and in 1961 a first jump magazine for the RPK machine gun was created. But it is a well-known fact that RPK magazines can be loaded in the AK rifles and vice versa. This feature was widely used by Soviet soldiers. During the Afghanistan War they used to attach drum magazines to the AKM rifles instead of RPK machine guns. RPK had almost no advantages over the AK, but was much heavier. The drum mags were scarce though, so when a soldier finished his tour in duty, he passed the mag onto his comrades, just like an heirloom is passed on in a family. And a precious heirloom it was. A mag like this increases ammo amount from 30 to 75 rounds, that means in 2.5 times. But why did the Russians almost completely abandon drum magazines, and what made them think they were actually a bad idea? First, drum magazines are more complex than standard box magazines. In box mags, the cartridges are fed by a spring that pushes them vertically from bottom to top. AK drum magazines have a circular belt spring. It's kind of like those wind-up cars our fathers used to play with when they were kids. This means that such a construction was more expensive to produce and less durable than standard magazines. Still, the Bubin drum mag for RPK and AK was really reliable. Never heard any Afghanistan war veterans say that drum mags were unreliable. But there are other reasons, such as the size of the magazine. Box magazines are flat and much easier to place on your gear. Drum magazines, on the other hand, are a real pain. While pouches for simple box magazines are everywhere, they are very hard to find for drums. It's much easier to fit 2 or even 3 AK box magazines than a single drum magazine. Geez, you can fit them anywhere, even in your pants or jacket pockets, but a drum can hardly fit anywhere at all. And this applies not only to AK and RPK magazines, but in general to any drums for any weapon. By the way, there's a myth that Soviet soldiers in World War II almost always used their submachine guns ppsh only with drum magazines. In fact, the Russians in World War II very quickly switched to box magazines because the drums were too much of an inconvenience, often failed and were harder to produce. Also, the drums of the RPK weighs 910 grams and the steel magazine of the AK-47 weighs 340 grams. That is, even by weight is it more advantageous to carry box magazines, especially since lighter models made of bakelite and plastic appear later. In the 60s, Soviet engineers tried to attach a drum magazine to the barrel of a Kalashnikov assault rifle. It's hard to believe, but this is not some fiction or rumor. These are literally technical solutions that Soviet engineers were working on. The effect is that at the time the Russians were very much concerned about the problem of the low accuracy of the AK rifle, and hanging a drum magazine under the barrel was one of the options. Interesting thing is that really worked. By increasing weight by 2 kg the gun became more stable, barrel recoil decreased and effectiveness of the burst was higher. But of course it didn't become something that really went into mass production, because the center of gravity and dimensions of the Kalashnikov assault rifle with a second drum magazine under the barrel became just awful. If you like learning about the crazy plans of Soviet gunsmiths, subscribe to the channel. The third reason why drums are a bad idea is that they are inconvenient to load with ammunition. It is much easier to load a simple AK box magazines with 30 or 40 rounds. Moreover, it doesn't have to be done by hand one round at a time. Standard magazines can be loaded through the clip. All you have to do is just put the adapter on AK magazine and insert the clip, then rest it against something hard and push it down. The drum magazine for RPK cannot do that, it can be loaded only one round manually, and each time you have to press the special lever in the front part of the magazine. Moreover, the drums make it difficult to control the gun in combat, as it quickly loses weight during firing due to the consumption of ammunition. For this reason, the way distribution of the weapon changes quickly, so you have to apply different effort to control the rifle. Also, you have to realize that drum magazines are always going to be more expensive to produce than 2-3 simple box magazines. Plus, if you drop an AK box magazine in a dirt and it stops working, just pull a new magazine out of the pouch and no problem. Headway, you lose 30 rounds of ammunition. I mean, the soldier will have to put the dirty magazine away, and when the fight is over and he's safe, he can clean it. Until then, it's best not to load it into the rifle, or you risk disabling your weapon completely. And if a soldier drops a drum magazine in the dirt, he will temporarily lose 50 or 75 rounds of ammunition in this way, or maybe even 100 rounds, depending on the magazine model. Therefore, when the Russians created the new RPK-74 machine gun in 1974 for the 5.5x39mm round, they did not make a drum magazine for it, but simply created an extended 45-round magazine. So the drum magazines remained only in old AKS of 7.62 caliber. My acquaintances from the FSB forces who conducted operations in the Chechen War always said that they took an AK-74 and extended 45-round magazines from the RPK-74 machine gun. And this was the best solution of all possible options, and none of them tried to carry an old AK and a drum magazine. Do you know why? That's another reason. The drum magazines from the RPK are very loud. They literally make a rattling noise because the cartridges inside it have backlash and are not stacked rigidly. And this, as you understand, is unacceptable during covert operations. But few people know that even after the AK-74 rifle and RPK-74 machine gun with conventional magazines appeared, the Soviets secretly continued to work on drum magazines. I assure you guys, you won't hear about this practically anywhere else. In 1981, engineers Vladimir Kamzolov, Valery Paranin and Yuri Shorobokov created two new models of drum magazines for the Kalashnikov weapons as part of a project called the PMB-3. The model on the right is called the M30. In essence, it's just an updated version of the old steel 75-round drum magazine from RPK, which received a case made of PSH polyamide, i.e. plastic. The model on the left is much more interesting. It was called the M100 and was designed from scratch for the 5.5x39 ammunition, which the Russians invented as a response to the American 5.56. This magazine held 100 rounds, only it was not a drum magazine, it was a disc magazine, also called pen magazine. Its difference is that the rounds in it are line bullets toward the center. The system literally works just like the Lewis machine gun magazines, with the cartridges piling upward during firing. The PMB-3 project was successful, but ultimately was never introduced into the Russian army. No one needed the drum magazines, so the project was closed and left to gather dust until better times, like many other Soviet inventions. Then, when Russia began developing the new RPK-16 machine gun, they remembered the PMB-3 project and its drum magazines. But in the end, the Russians never got around to producing them, because over the years they simply lost the technology that had once been developed. M100 and M30 type magazines were shown several times in exhibitions and presentations, but they never got any further than polished tables with lights. And the old 7.62 caliber drum magazines are not made in Russia anymore. There are very few of them left from those years, so it would be almost impossible to catch a Russian army soldiers carrying one.